And so here again, Esau and Jacob, they're both you. They're not simply historical characters. I have no question whatsoever that Esau and Jacob were historical characters. If you ever go to the upper room in Jerusalem, downstairs is Jacob's tomb. I passed many of those historical sites renowned in the Bible while in the Holy Land. And all of that is historically valid. But here again, every character in the Bible is some aspect of yourself, some aspect of man, every man. Every place in the Bible is some aspect of you, of every man. The Sermon on the Mount is prefaced by words that go something like this. And Jesus went up into a high mountain, and when he was set, his disciples came unto him, and he taught them, saying. Now, it mentions a mountain. What is this really saying? The theologians never got past the geographical spot, the spatial aspect of the matter. But Jesus going up into a high mountain means the master person ascending to a high spiritual state of consciousness. And it was from a high spiritual state of consciousness that Jesus taught his disciples of the disciplines of his own mind. But I'm showing you all of this, and I'm purposely redundant when it comes to these principles. You're really never going to understand the Bible until you come to understand that the Bible is really the revelation of you, and that every character in the Bible is some revelation of you. I went into something in the last lesson also that I listened to today that I thought was interesting. You remember I even told you that all the animals are in you? Yes. You see, to tell you the truth, everything is in man. Everything. And even the things that seem to be out there, they're not really out there. They're in here, in consciousness. I mean, you're always saying, she's just like a dog. He's just like a dog. Just like a snake. Eats like a hog. You see how all the animals are in you? The scripture says in one place that the lion shall lie down with the lamb. You see, and the lion and the lamb are in you. Who's the lion? The lion is that raging, beastly emotion within the spiritually undisciplined man. Who's the lamb? That is the purity, the gentleness, the calmness, the innocence of the spiritually aware man. And when the lion lies down with the lamb, it means that the animal side of man's nature comes to peace with the spiritual side of his nature. That same thing happens in our lesson tonight at the very end. At the very end, Esau and Jacob are reconciled. The body and the spirit become reconciled. At the very end of the lesson tonight, it shows us Esau and Jacob rushing toward one another in reconciliation, hugging and kissing as brothers, and weeping on each other's neck in loving reconciliation. What's that? That's not just two people hugging and kissing. Well, you're my brother and I haven't seen you for a long time and I'm sorry about our misunderstanding. Yes, that was a part of it, but if you go no further than that, as most theologians do, you've missed the whole thing. Esau and Jacob hugging and kissing and weeping on one another's neck and coming to a peace and understanding. That's you. That is your fleshly nature, your human nature, coming to peace with your spiritual nature, saying we are brothers. We have the same father. We are from the same source. We understand our right relationship. And we accept each other in that right relationship in the Father. Now, in the master person, mind governs and takes precedent over matter, body and affairs. Divine intuition governs and takes precedence over the mind of the flesh, the external senses. In the master person, the inner self governs and takes precedence over the outer self. The invisible governs and takes precedent over the visible. Saint Francis of Assisi called his physical body Brother Ass. If the self, a person, permits the animal, body-sense self, to govern and take precedence over the inner spirit, divine mind self, he indeed becomes a jackass and a slave to the body, materiality, and conditions. Again, I told you that, you know, all of the animals are in every man. Now, since you know that even all the animals are in you, you have to know how to keep them in order. And why are we in this class? Why do we engage in all of this spiritual study? To come to that place in consciousness that the Bible talks about where the lion lies down with the lamb. Now, God bless the dear Christian theologians, but, you know, they say, now, this is when we all get to heaven. After we all die and go through the graveyard. And then someday in the future, we don't know when it's going to happen, but Jesus is going to come back. He's on vacation now. He's at the beach getting a suntan somewhere. He's up in heaven while we're down here catching hell. But someday he's going to have mercy on us and he's going to come back. And if we have been washing behind our ears and saying our prayers, then he's going to take us to paradise way up in the sky. And there's going to be peace then, and the lion will lie down with the lamb. Oh, what a beautiful place that's going to be. That place is in you. You're not going to get to that place spatially until you get to that place in you first. I like the way Reverend Ike says it. When you find the heaven that is within you, then you will find yourself in heaven, but not till then. All right. The lion and the lamb, as I say, they're within you. The jackass is in you too. And I'm going to skip around on this a bit. You know, I'll skip around in this lesson. You take it and read it if you want to be intellectual about it later. I'm going to skip around on this. What do you think Jesus riding the ass into Jerusalem means? Now, in this case, Jerusalem represents the self. It means that within yourself, you should ride your animal nature instead of letting your animal nature ride you. You should ride the ass instead of letting the ass ride you. Because if you let the ass ride you, it will make an ass out of you. And as I've said in other lessons, you know, when you find those animals and they're getting in the wrong place, you better learn to talk to them and say, down, boy. Come on, let me hear you say it.
Down,
down, boy. Down, boy. Let me give you some control. We're talking about being a master person in this lesson. And you see, when you know yourself, and if you notice, I'm introducing you to yourself. Some of you in the past few minutes, you've learned some things about yourself that you didn't even know. No wonder the Greeks said and inscribed it upon the entrance to the temple at Adelphi, these immortal words, man, know thyself. And you see, once you learn that everything is within you, then you have control. Then you become a master person. All right, let me show you how to talk to these animals. Let me show you how to handle that jackass that's within you. All right? Down, boy.
Down, boy.
Let's say it. Come on.
Down, boy.
So Jesus rides the ass into Jerusalem. Jerusalem representing the self. Jesus representing the spiritual man, the spiritual consciousness, the master person, the Christed one, the Son of God nature must ride the son of a gun. the son of a gun will ride him. See? And make no mistake about it, one's going to ride the other. But just as Esau, the older son, and again, as I say, you see, the animal nature comes first. In the twin nature of man, the animal nature comes first. This is the meaning of Esau being the oldest son. He gets preeminence first. He comes first. Man knows himself from the animal side, the body side, the material side first. But that process has got to be reversed. And I must come to know the other side of my nature, the Jacob side of my nature. And it must take over. But you see, Esau doesn't want to give up. And when he finds that Jacob, the younger brother, of the newfound spiritual knowledge, has done something to take over preeminence and lordship, he says, I'm going to kill it. This is why sometimes you find it such a hard time when you really begin to apply your spiritual disciplines. Some people say, oh, Reverend Ike, you know, since I started studying this positive thinking, you know, oh, looks like everything is just kicking up. You know why? Because you're stirring up all those old negatives. The old body conscience, the old jackass has been riding you so long, he doesn't want to get down so you can ride him. That old temper has been flinging off so long like a pack of wild horses. You see, remember I told you last week that the wild horses or the galloping horses represented the wild emotions out of control. And you see, the body consciousness, the jackass consciousness, has been just taking you wherever it wanted to take you. and galloping away with you and riding you. It doesn't want to give that up. The body has had control of you. It'll make you jump up and run to the refrigerator every 10 minutes when you know you shouldn't. Uh-oh. And you'd better learn to say what? Down, boy. Am I body controlled? And let's recite it. Am I body controlled?
Am I body controlled?
You see, the Esau tendency in man is body controlled. Say that again. Am I body controlled? And again, Jacob taking Esau's blessing means that the person reaches a point where he takes his control from the body and gives it to the spirit. You say, down, boy. And up, spirit.
I know I've been changed. I know I've been changed. Changed. The angels in the heaven have changed my name.